We just had a big update for Modern Warfare and Warzone, and in today's video I will just be going over the main changes. You'll notice a lot of the file size was due to bug fixes. So in this update they added a few new modes, new features, of course bug fixes, and finally some new cosmetics that we will be seeing in the store soon. And speaking of cosmetics, yes, we're doing another giveaway this week. Two separate people will be winning 1100 COD points, and all you gotta do is just follow my things, link to that down below, picking a winner on Saturday if you want to enter that link down below. So modes for the week, they added Blueprint Gunfight. So it's the same old gunfight, but it has a new name to point out that it features weapon variants that are from the store. So the idea is maybe you'll see a variant and you're gonna like it and maybe you'll buy it. So personally, I'm not falling for it, but with all the interesting colors and designs, it's a lot more fun, more exciting than what we had before, which is, you know, just stock weapons, no camo, you know, kind of boring. So personally, I feel that this should be the default going forward. Yes, their intentions are to sell you weapon variants, but it does make the mode a little more exciting, more colorful, so I'm all for it. Next up is Reinfected Ground War. They did do a few tweaks to it. So it's good old infected, but with up to 48 players. And even though the infected, they still win 90% of the time. So hey, looking to bump up your win-loss record, there you go. Just play some infected. But if you're a survivor and you can get into a nice spot like Bobby here, you can get all your streaks and just go to town. Yes, you get a sentry gun, you get a juggernaut, and it can get pretty crazy. You can rack up a lot of easy kills. But with that said, any deaths that you get in infected, they do not count towards your KD ratio. It's been that way for a couple years now. And the thing is, not many players, they don't know that. They don't want to mess up their KD ratio. Maybe they're new to infected and they don't understand that infected doesn't count that. It does count the kills though. It does count that. It does not count the deaths. And what happens is a lot of people end up leaving the game because they get frustrated. And you know what? I don't blame them. So I'm thinking that the streaks, they may be a little overkill. Otherwise, it's a really fun party mode. It's a great way to grind XP for your battle pass. If you're just, you know, watching a show in the background, listening to a podcast, or you just want to chill way to play the game, you don't feel like sweating. So that's why I personally like infected. After that, it's 3v3 cranked gunfight. And what it is, once you get a kill, you've got 10 seconds to get another kill before you blow up and die. So they took two of my favorite modes. They took cranked, gunfight, put them together. So you think I'd love it, right? Yeah, no. I mean, it definitely speeds up the gameplay, you know, with only having 10 seconds to find another person. But the whole reason I like gunfight was because it was like a nice balance of being fun, but also tactical, fast, kind of fast gameplay, but not too fast. But with cranked gunfight, it's just way too fast. And not to mention, if you're the last alive on your team, just hide. All you gotta do is hide from the other person, since you know they have 10 seconds to find you before they blow themselves up. Okay, so that's not exactly tactical. It's I don't know what it is, but I do appreciate Infinity Ward trying new modes or giving us new content, but this one, it just isn't for me, but who knows, maybe you'll love it. And then finally for multiplayer, we have Shoot the Ship 24/7. This has cranked and grind, and you guys already know what this mode is. Everyone loves it. Small maps, quick playlists, perfect for grinding camo challenges. So really not much to speak on here, but don't forget that there is a hardcore variant hidden near the bottom of the hardcore playlist section. And this is great since every weapon in hardcore is like one or two shot kill. So if you're getting a lot of hit markers with whatever gun you're working on, hey, why not just give the hardcore variant a shot? Hey, great for pistols, great for shotguns. There you go. Okay, let's talk about Warzone. They did, past tense, had a most wanted contract, but it only lasted a day before they removed it, right before I made this video. So instead of a random operator being marked on your TAC map, you are voluntarily putting a bounty on yourself for any squad to see you on the map. And it sounds fun on paper, but it didn't take very long to figure out that all you gotta do is have a vehicle nearby. And when you pop the most wanted contract, get in that vehicle, get in your truck, get in your helicopter, and then you hide. Just drive around, fly around, and that's all you do. You know, find some distant place on the map. If someone shoots at you, get out of there. And you can see the problem with this. In a mode where half the people are hiding and camping, why would you reward them for that? It doesn't make any sense. As of this recording, it's been removed and good old bounties are back. You can look at the mini map. It's just bounties everywhere. And that is my favorite way to play Warzone, since it promotes conflict and it's easy cash, whether you get the kill or some other team does. You know, if someone poaches your bounty, you know, you get like $1,000, so easy money. A few other changes they added to Warzone, besides the new satchel backpack that lets you carry 8 armor plates, is the cargo truck. The cargo truck has been nerfed and they added it back to BR solos. And what it is it now has reduced turning speed, reduced acceleration, and a reduced top speed, because that thing was pretty much like a dune buggy, except big Bertha. And the rest is just a bunch of bug fixes, tweaks, linked all that stuff down below. It's really not very exciting. So let's move on to cosmetics. I'm going to be showing off some of the more interesting stuff. They did add a lot of stuff, like 31 new items, but let's take a look at some of the stuff that I think is pretty cool. If you want to see everything, I will have a link to codtracker.gg. That's where all this is coming from. And let's have a look. So most of these are leaked, no idea when or if they're coming. They're probably coming. We just don't know when they're going to be in the game. And this was all included in that big update, a lot of this stuff. So for the Uzi, we have the J-Pop Pop, Cuteness Reload, Faithful Companion, which is a little waifu pillow, and the Senpai Truck. Wow. That, you know what? It's kind of funny looking. I actually like that. So this is part of Anime Express, $1,600, or 1,600 COD points. 1,600 COD points. And again, link to this website, tracker.gg, if you want to check out everything. Next one I found interesting is Avant-Garde, 1100 COD points. And by the way, what is up with these thumbnails that don't even show the gun stuff? I think that's a little weird. But here for the Auger, we have Abstract. So if you like black and green, here you go for your Model 680 and your Auger. Pretty cool emblem, little sticker, and colorful animated calling card. Up next is Fireclaw 3, and it's a guy with his tiger. Wonder what prompted them to get this thumbnail. But here you go. It has by the toe, catch a tiger by the toe, also for the Auger. Hey, you know what? That actually looks pretty cool. You get a king spray and a big kitty cat charm. We also got another operator coming, Iskra operator bundle. This is going to be 2400 COD points. She does have a tracer pack with her, and you get Saboteur, and you can't really see the whole model, so I can't really judge it, but there you go. Always welcome new female models, and you get Insurgency for the FR5.56, and for the Desert Eagle, we have the Hearsay, and these are actually pretty clean. You get the Savagery camo for your helicopter, Flood Plane Watch. It actually does look kind of plain. And knife, got the Carver finishing move. Unfortunately, you can't really preview it. She does have an animated calling card and a animated emblem. Up next is Lumber Tactical, 2000 COD points. And this includes the Bunyan skin for Reigns. You know, again, we can't see the entire thing, but I'm sure he's gonna be here this week or next week. For the M91, you get the saw blade. And for the 725, the loggerhead. So kind of like a lumberjack theme, animated emblem. He has a quip, got a blue bowl, and a animated calling card. And here's something interesting. So now they're going to be selling vehicle packs. So here's the plunder pack. So here's Fancy for the Jeep. You've seen this Jeep on the back of the Gunrunner multiplayer map. So now there's a whole set. You can have a blinged out tank if you want. The helicopter, that actually looks pretty neat. Gold and black camo for all your vehicles. If you just, you know, just want to floss on everyone, 1200 COD points for the plunder pack. So again, I will have a link down below if you guys want to check out all the leaked stuff. And remember, this Saturday, two of you are winning 1100 COD points. Link down below to enter that. All you gotta do is just follow my socials like you already are. And yeah, there you go. Really doesn't take much to it. I have switched from Mixer back to Twitch. I will explain that in a separate video, but yes, I am back on Twitch. A lot of people weren't exactly happy with Mixer. You know what? Neither was I, but that is right now is not the time or place for that. Links to all my stuff down below. Please take 3 seconds to no scope that like button on the left side of the video, right side of the video, and I will see you guys next time.